It's my surname, Ponte.
Ponte is your surname?
Yes. Okay. But what's the reason of the trees like that?
So probably in the previous vlog, the bus driver brought us to the wrong city. Therefore we went to the capital of Kosovo, and finally, after taking another bus, after losing, I don't know, maybe 3-4 hours, how many did we lose? I don't know, we don't know. We are finally getting to the hotel, and this one, it's incredibly the cheapest 4-star hotel I found in Europe. I cannot wait to show it to you, and let's hope we'll find some food, not just chips. Let's hope we'll have a beautiful night. Everywhere on the street they are selling such dresses, which they look incredible. Oh my goodness, oh, she's losing it. Her boobs are appearing. Everywhere they do sell such dresses, and right now we are running to the hotel. It's freezing over here, even for kids.
Wow.
This city already looks very, very beautiful and pretty. I cannot wait to show it during the day.
Sì, sicuramente è potabile.
So we passed through the center and now we are on the side roads where they still show some kind of pretty interesting dresses, especially for women. And now we are gonna get to our hotel. It's a 4-star hotel and the price was incredible. 35 euros, which is less than $40. Divided by 2 because we are in 2, and now we're gonna see what do you get with a 4-star hotel here in Kosovo, in the, let's say, east-south of Europe. Wow, I cannot wait, guys.
There is Pal Paluka, interesting statue of a warrior, probably a national hero. What else we got? Oh my goodness, after so many hours we are finally getting here. That's incredible, Joe. Astonishing. Eccolo.
Hello. Hello. Ciao.
We have a reservation.
Michele Ponte.
Yeah, we called because we are late.
Okay. We are late. Yeah. Yeah, because our bus driver.
Okay, stop.
They
broke us
not to Prisina.
Okay, don't worry about it.
I should bring it, don't worry.
Don't worry about it.
Ah, okay. Oh, that's perfect, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
So guys, welcome to this 4-star hotel. As always, there are beds, which, I mean, that's the only thing I care about. There is a phone. These 2 bottles of water. A TV. Does it open? Oh, it opens. And there is a fridge, which is empty. As often happens in many countries where they do not trust you. And apart the beds, we have wardrobe, towels, and there is this bathroom where, I mean, looks nice, nothing special. Is it still recording? Yeah. And there is a shower, the noodle shower or spaghetti shower, I would call it, and also this other type of shower, which looks a bit like a telephone. Anyway, probably that's it for this room. Tomorrow we are gonna have the breakfast, so you are gonna see the breakfast. We'll see what do you get in a 4-star hotel here in the Baltic, here in the Slavic, no, come in che country siamo?
Kosovo.
Kosovo fa parte delle...
Slave?
No. Here in Kosovo, which is called the Balkani, here in the Balkans countries. At night, we did walk for a few hundred meters and we went to this restaurant called Tesila. Probably my pronunciation is not correct. Anyway, we didn't know what to order, so the waiter decided to showcase everything to us, and we decided directly in front of the chef. Practically, what we decided was everything. We decided that we must try everything, and therefore we chose like one plate of everything, and this whole meat ended up on our table.
This type of meat is very soft and I sell it especially in the Balkans. I tried something similar also in North Macedonia a few months ago, and the kebabi, these little fingers, they are the trusted meat by Luka Doncic, one of my favorite basketball players right now. All this gorgeous food did cost us just a little bit more than $10 per person. And I paid also for Giovanni because I decided that I should celebrate my birthday for the whole weekend.
So guys, it's the morning after, the nightlife isn't so exceptional.
The best club in Prizren is called Ponte Prime. Maybe I'm the owner, who knows?
And we found some dust over here, but who cares? Also this lighting, does it work? I don't know, let's leave it here. And now we are going for the breakfast. Ce l'hai tu le chiavi?
Ok.
So guys, let's see what they will bring us for breakfast. There we have all the clocks, which we are not able to read because nowadays you see the clock on the phone, but we're gonna be fine. And Giovanni is playing Fantacalcio, which is fantasy football.
Yes.
But for the Americans, soccer. And here we are outside the hotel. HP always remembers me about Harry Potter, one of my favorite novels growing up. And right now I'm checking the weather. Let's see if it's cold. We're probably gonna go up there. There is a castle. And that's the road that we did yesterday night. We are kind of in the suburbs, but it's just about like 500 meters from the center, or even less. Here we got our espresso and some butter. Come si dice marmellata? Nobody knows how to call this cream in English. Here we are, it looks very very nice. Already started the espresso and Giovanni is still playing
Fantacalcio.
Addicted.
Yeah. Three league.
Giovanni wants three things. Such a waste of money. And now we're gonna go explore the city.
Just wanted to show you this building because it has been cut from one side, so it's pretty slim. What do you think, Geoff?
About?
The building. Did you notice it's like a ship, a navy, a boat? And anyway, now we are gonna go up to that castle.
Prizren is the most touristic city here in Kosovo. Giovanni is waiting for me to finish the vlog over there. We have a tower, we have a church. And you're gonna see many churches and many mosques during this little trip, and well, and that's it. Jova, I do not know what to say.
Me too.
Now we are gonna see a beautiful bridge that connects the city north to south, and we are approaching the city center, which to me it's amazing. Every time I see a pedestrian street, I'm happy. So as you can see, in these countries they do love to sit and eat and drink on bars. Here there is another important part of the city, but we also do not know anything about it. Here I just want to show you one thing. It's important. No photos, no smoking, no guns and no skirts. This one is the main square of the city. At night there are so many lights, it looks amazing. And now we are gonna go to that bridge so we can give you a beautiful look and a panoramic view of this amazing place. As I was telling you guys, in the Balkans they do love to sit outside, have a coffee and talk for the whole day. And now we are approaching the historic bridge, which yesterday night we passed, and we weren't so able to see it. So we have mountains on the right side with some snow on the top, the whole city, Giovanni, some mosque, the river, a beautiful panoramic view, and the castle over there.
So one pretty interesting thing about the city is that lots of trees, they have this wool around them, which is pretty nice. Again, the stone bridge with this view is amazing, but there are so many interesting things to discover, and I wish we had the free walking tour, but on Saturday they do not work because it's low season right now. Maybe that's why everything was so cheap. Imagine that yesterday, how much was the beer in that pub?
Cool, nice.
No, 1.50 euro?
1.50 euro.
Yeah, less than $2 for one beer. Amazing for a pub. And also, we were in a club which is called Ponte Prime, and the cocktails were 2.75 euro. Less than $3 per cocktail. We were shocked. Another interesting thing is that every hero of the country is a warrior, a soldier. This country had lots of war in the past 20 years, so they're still recovering from it. And well, since that they are doing well. Also, Giovanni has a friend that works for, how do you call it, international organization?
Yes, organization, yes.
Yeah, to help people in this country. And he's in Pristina, the capital. And, well, at first they brought aids, then they brought food. What else did they brought here? I don't know. Doctors, medicines, they were helping as much as possible. And again, over here there are also these trees. There are always these trees. I don't know. Joe, I think we should stop someone and ask an explanation.
About?
The trees. Also about Ponte. Hello? No, it's my surname, Ponte.
Ponte is your surname?
Yes. Okay. I don't know. But what's the reason of the trees like that?
I don't know.
You don't know, really? But it's always like that, or?
No, in all trees is like this.
Ah, okay. Well, thank you. Bye.
Lo sa manco lui, no?
So, yeah. Not even the locals, they don't know why there are these things around the trees. So we start going to the top to go find this castle.
Yeah, you will enjoy it. You will love it.
Thank you very much.
For sure, the local drink, arak.
Arak.